touch.
Appreciate it. A one touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. And that one bounces out of the back of the end zone, so we'll start the drive at the 25 on the touchback. Murray and the Cardinals with a first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Third quarter starts with a run from Connor. And they're able to get this one across the 35. They've got the lead early here in the third quarter, and runs like that are how they establish that lead in the first half.
I love the fact that you're using the word lead, because they are leading from the front, pounding on the defense right now with the running game, and truly establishing themselves here in the second half.
Flush to his right. Murray has it knocked loose. Fumble. And it's picked up by the Eagles.
So turnovers, Charles, you figure will be key in the second half, and that's a big giveaway there.
Yeah, and as you and I both know, coaches are always preaching ball security, and none more often than right here in the second half of a tight football game. Now you've got to believe what the coaches are saying and take care of that football.
On first and 10, it's Hurts. It's caught by Sanders. It'll go down as a gain of 6. And it's a second down.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice, safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
It's a second down run with Sanders. And he'll take this down for about 4 yards, down to the 15. Pretty good job defensively. Thought he was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was, and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize that strategic football and situational football is not just played on the offensive side, is it? Defense understanding, as you noted, where the first down marker was and making sure they didn't get there.
And he is going to have an Eagles first down as they're able to convert, albeit not by much, on third and a yard. From the 13 now, they work on first and 10. Here's Hurts to throw. Escaping the pressure right. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. He'll get 3 yards on the scramble there at second down.
How about a tip of the cap to the defense? They're working against a very mobile quarterback, but all day long they've kept him under wraps. And on that play, they held him to a short gain.
Throwing again on second down. Hurts. And the timing a bit off that time as that one falls to the ground. Defensively, Charles, they continue to really limit this offense as far as yardage goes.
Yeah, you're exactly right. They've been assignment sound, staying in their lanes, keeping proper leverage, and communicating well, too.
Eluding the pressure right. Hard throw, incomplete.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable. And that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they brought the heat, and if he flushes out, they're fine with that, and they force another incompletion.
It hurts not coming to the sideline. They're going to go for it. Fourth down with Hurts. And this is caught. That's Watkins. And he takes this down to about the 2 before going out of bounds. Both sides were holding their breath there on that fourth down play, and the offense can breathe a sigh of relief.
And both knew exactly where the first down markers were. You know the defense is trying to guard those sticks and try and keep people in front, but somehow, some way, those guys found a way to pick it up.
They'll try to run with Sanders. And he will take this one in for an Eagle touchdown. Miles Sanders taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Eagles move back within a couple of the lead. Now that Eagle offense will stay out there as he'll go for two. They'll turn to Sanders, and he'll get in to tie this game at 8. And they're able to ground it in there on the two-point try, and you and I were talking before the game that two-point conversions from the 15-16 season, what has changed? What happened?
Their normal strategy, because now you're either kicking the football with the ball on the 15-yard line, or if you decide to go for two, they put it on the 2-yard line. So what are you thinking as a coach? Do I risk it? Do I go for it here? Do I try and gain a strategic advantage and maybe go for two early? That's what people are wondering about.
Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And they had the fumble last time that led to a touchdown. That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this go around.
A big no-no. Put that in capital letters. Turning it over, the other team takes it down and scores. That can be a deflator for a football team. Now it's up to the offense to get back out on the field and pick things up.
Yeah, they're out there. We'll see if they can pick those things back up. On first and 10 is Connor. And this will be good for a pickup of 9 to the 46.
Kenny had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. Connor going to get it again on second down. Oh, a heck of a move.
Man.
And some space here. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. 57 yards rushing for him now on just 6 carries to this point. So from Philadelphia territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 27. And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. They'll run on first down, Edmonds. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. From the gun, Murray. Flushed out right. Hopkins on the grab over the middle. And they'll get this down to the 10.
Partner in a tie game in the fourth quarter, you and I both know in the NFL, that's when you lean on your stars, and he came through with a nice catch right there.
Set him back 5. The delay of game, a costly one, as they're backed up 5 for first and goal. Here's Murray. Dancing to his left. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. Nifty job there on the scramble. Got 12 yards. And now it's second down.
Man, defensively, that hurts. They got him out of his rhythm. They had him hemmed in. But somehow he was able to tuck it away and get away for a gain.
So the ball position now at the three. Here's second and goal. Play fake. Murray. And it's caught. Touchdown, Cardinals. Darrell Daniels from 3 yards out. And the Cardinals have taken the lead. So, Charles, this game feels like it has been punch, counterpunch all throughout. And that touchdown breaks our tie here in the fourth quarter.
You're making me want to get back in the gym and start training again. You talk about those punches and counterpunches. I also think this is where you and I start thinking to ourselves, who's going to make the play to change that, right? Who's going to get out of this little cycle that they're in right now and make a play and give their team a firm advantage?
After the touchdown, out is Prater to kick. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And now, after the touchdown a moment ago, they work from behind in a 7-point game in this fourth quarter. Plenty of time on the clock. They'll try and start this drive in the air. And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down.
That's an excellent play by the defender. He diagnosed that one, closed quickly, and helped force the incompletion.
On second and 10, Hurts looking again for Watkins, and this time that's complete. And they work this well upfield across the 45. On first down, he'll drop to throw. He's going to launch this thing way downfield. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Robert Alford. And the Cards are going to take over once again at their own 37-yard line.
Brandon, offensively, this has been a tough day for them. Trying to find a place to throw the football, it's been extremely difficult. I've got to give a lot of credit to the secondary, especially the corners who've had the receivers on lockdown.
Arizona's offense at the line, ready to get their drive started. They had to go a long way on their last drive to score the touchdown. This time, they get at least a little bit more of a cushion with field position.
I have to think that with this field position, after what they did on the last drive, they might want to take a shot right now and try and cut down the length of the drive. Oh, that's got to frustrate him a little bit because they nearly got to him there, and it would have been the first sack of the game instead. They're able to influence the release, and they did force the incomplete pass.
On second down now, it's Connor. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a third and 8 coming up. After that run, still a good amount of meat on the bone here for this third down play. Can you envision them putting this in the air?
Totally. I mean, look at who he has under center right now. If you can't trust him with the football, you can't trust anyone. And frankly, to me, I want the ball down the stretch. Get the first down, keep it in the hands of my offense. I don't want to turn it over to them and rely on my D.
Powers through him. Ertz has it left side. And he'll go out of bounds, it appears, right at the 45. The completion good for only 6, and that'll bring up fourth. I hate to surrender the foot. Hey, trust that defense.
It's the right play at this stage of the game as well. You don't need to press it here because you do have that little bit of a cushion, and you count on your D to make it stand up.
And here's a big one now. Try to hold this lead. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. To throw is Murray. On the slant, complete to Hopkins. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. We've got a one-score game with inside of 2 minutes remaining.
So the Cardinals, they've got the football here as we get you reset. They've got a first and 10 as they look to try and finish this one off. On first down, Connor. And I think this defense knew what was coming as he is smothered behind the line. And quickly, we're going to get another stop here with 1:54 left as they call the timeout defensively. So the first down run lost a couple. Now they come up second and 12. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. So two plays with only negative yardage to show, and now it's third and 16. Back to throw, Murray. Flush to his right. Looking deep for his tight end, Ertz. That's caught inside the 20. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. A big play that time through the air. 30 yards. So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. Murray a give. This is Connor. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down, and it's second down. Looked like he was trying to bounce it outside, but no success.
Yeah, sometimes you got to just figure out where you're going to go, and sometimes you just have to take it to another spot. And trying to get it outside, the defensive pursuit was there and just ran him down.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again second and 10. Now a give to Edmonds. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. Call it a gain of 5 that time, and they'll be left with a third.